Hey, how y'all doing today? This is your girl, Giselle, the She Boss, okay? I'm back at you. I'm back again at you with another episode of Cookin' with a Concept. All right, so tonight is one of the family faves, especially for a Saturday night. For those of you all that are looking for some meal ideas and don't have a whole lot to do, I love this because it can easily feed at least a family of four with a small piece of meat. This is all I have right here. So, once we get all the toppings and everything on it, it really like stretches out and does something for the stomach, okay? And it's actually good comfort food too. So I already have prepped the toppings that I'm going to be putting on it. So we have tomatoes, I have some pickles, I have some olives, I have some onions, and I have some jalapeno pepper, okay? And so in this bowl right here, I have the toppings that I'm going to actually be putting in my Rotel, and these are some bell peppers, some fresh mushrooms, and some onions as well, some yellow onions. I chopped those up. Right here I have some I have a little olive oil, and I have some imperial butter. I also have some shredded lettuce that I'll be using, and we are going to be using these Tostitos scoop for our Rotel dip. All right, I love the scoop. They're shaped like little scoop bowls, if y'all have seen those, all right? And I also have some medium cheddar. This is what I'll be putting in my dip sauce. And this is what we'll be putting on top of our Rotel. That is the taco blend cheese, okay? That's just a store brand. Got that from Walmart. I have a half a pack of the original taco seasoning, and I just got this new cheesy taco flavor, so I'm gonna just kind of sprinkle a little bit of that in there, okay? And I have a couple of my favorite seasonings, the adobo, the gabo, nature season. All right, I don't have all of my seasonings over here, but I have some of them. I got some lares and some parsley flakes and sea salt, okay? And also for additional toppings, of course, this is optional, but it's all about what you like. I like guacamole. I use submarine salad on mine. And I'm also going to be using some minced garlic in the Rotel dip. And I like salsa verde and regular salsa, so I'll be using a little bit of that for mine as well. So let's go ahead and get started. First, what we're going to do is we're going to saute these vegetables. And I'm just going to put them in here. I like to put like a tablespoon of marge, okay, and then I put like two topfuls of the olive oil to saute my veggies in, okay. And since I'm going to be mixing all this together, I won't have to do any transfers when I get ready to start cooking the meat, okay, and grounding the meat. All right, so put this up. Oh, and I also have Chi Chi's mild sauce. Ooh, that's what I've been using for the sauce, okay? Let that melt down a little bit. So, while I'm thinking about it, when you get a chance, go ahead and go down below, click on the subscribe button, okay? If you like the content on this video, or if you have some ideas or some meals that you would like to do or submit, let me just give you a little bit of background about me. I actually went to culinary school, so I love to cook, all right? So I am actually a certified chef, and I like to do what I call freestyle cooking. So I take a lot of recipes that other people make and just put my own touch to it, so... although I don't want to be a cook, a professional cook, I do like hosting and entertaining, so I figured what better way than to use my YouTube channel and my cooking skills to combine it and come up with this. And also for those of you that don't know, I am a convicted felon and I've been to prison before, so the name of the episode or the series, Cooking with a Concept, has a concept to it, and that is the concept, okay? Even though I don't consider myself a convict or a con artist or anything like that, that is a past lifestyle, but some of these recipes that I'm using on this channel are based off of some of the things that I actually created, recipes that I came up with in prison, okay? So they're a little bit different, of course, because I'm home and I'm free now. But, like I said, some of them got their origin from their situation. So, sometimes you can take a bad situation and turn it around to something good, okay? It doesn't always end up as it looks as if it may, okay? So, the beginning never usually looks like the end. So, y'all keep that in mind when you're going through something and you're down. Try to take a bad situation and get the best out of it that you can, okay? Sometimes things just look a little gloomy, but the good weather is usually always on the other side, all right? So, that's a little something for y'all. So, basically, what I'm doing is just going to kind of soft fan. I'm not going to do nothing too heavy. Let them get a little warm aroma. So, yeah. I got to open up my garlic because I got a new batch. I love cooking with garlic. Anybody else out there with me on that? All right. I am just a garlic fanatic. All right. All right. And also, when you get a chance, go on over to visit the website if you're looking for some consultation services, if you have a small business, or you're interested in some image consulting, if you're interested in marketing, branding your business, all right? You need a website built, or if you need a website hosting, you need data, analytical data, and SEO optimizations for your social media platform. Give me a call or text at 404-507-4805, or you can go on over to the website. That's www.sheboss21inc. As you can see, you can Google me, okay? Go on over and schedule your free 30-minute strategy session today, okay? Even if you don't know what you want to do, it's always a good idea to maybe have somebody to toss ideas back and forth between, okay? Sometimes we can't think about it all, and sometimes we just don't know enough to think about it. Let me get add a little bit of butter in here while I'm thinking about this and kind of just gauge it. I like butter, but I don't like to use a whole lot. I prefer the oil. But you can just kind of decide how much you need based on how many the vegetables you're using, okay? So this is pretty much what you want the consistency of it. This is a good little saute, because keep in mind, you don't have to get them all super soft. They're going to cook down more after you add them to the meat, okay? So we're just going to go ahead and transfer those over to the bowl. Turn the heat back up on that. Go ahead and drop that guy. Put that in the trash room. So, when I ground mine, I like to go ahead and break my meat on down into chunks. It helps it cook quicker, better, in a more consistent manner. Because you're kind of basically like getting all the meat flattened at the bottom of the pot. And so it all kind of cooks consistently. When you leave them in big chunks, you'll have some parts that cook quicker than others. You may find yourself turning it up too high and overcooking it or cooking it too quick. So that's just something that I prefer to do. Let that get browned on the bottom. All right. And I let mine, I like to let it cook about halfway or so, a little bit over halfway before I start adding flavors and seasonings, just because of the drainage that might come actually grounding the meat. And so basically having to, you know, pour the grease out and drain it out. I don't want the flavor to get rinsed out with the liquid. So I let it cook down a little bit until it actually stops doing so much of the draining. And then once it does that, I'll go ahead and start adding my seasonings, all right? And just depending on how high, I have mine on 5. Of course, your temperature may vary according to how your stove does. This is my good eye right here, the one right which is perfect for me. So it does a pretty good job of cooking the meat pretty thoroughly, all right? It already smells good, even though I haven't done anything to it. Cooking up good. And then once I add the meat to it, once I add the the seasonings to it, I'll come right behind it with the extra vegetables that we already sauteed. I'm gonna add some cheese in it, and then I will let that cheese melt down in the meat, and then I will go ahead and start opening my top up to see them. I will add the salsa at the end. And let that cook down a little bit as well. All right. And that's pretty much what I do as far as making my dip. And I'll show y'all the finishing touches as well. And I have, I got the squeezed garlic because I didn't feel like cutting up garlic. Sometimes, like, when I'm doing garlic and onions, it's just too much. I don't want all that smell on my hands. So, I chose the easy route tonight, okay? So, y'all don't judge me on that. And, as you can see, it's ground up real good. And we're getting that excess liquid right there, okay, on the side, if y'all can see that. Can't tell about too much, but y'all see it over there. So that's what you want to wait on, at least one or two rounds of that. Like I said, depending on how this is ground beef, and I'm not really a big meat eater, but you know, still got to cook for the fam because they're not really on so much of a health cook. But we're all, you know, we eat when we want to. So if we want some meat, we will eat some meat. All right. So y'all don't worry about if you you do it. It's just not what you do. It's just about how you do it. We don't eat a lot of it, but when we do, we try to enjoy it. I'm going to go ahead and drain this in the sink. So, yes, now I'm getting ready to add the seasoning. I'm going to turn this down just a little bit. Let it cook. Turn down about 3.5. All right, so I'm putting my garlic in there. Got a little bit of that Lauren. You from the South, y'all know what that's about. All right. Then go ahead and just swoosh that thing on around there. Now, I'm just a parsley fan. Y'all forgive me, but I be a little fancy with mine. All right, so throw some parsley up in that thing like I do. And I was going to use some spinach, and I don't know why I won't. I think I just forgot. But, and I didn't give it a chance to thaw out, so I'm not going to be able to use it this time. But if you want to add some spinach to this dish, it will give it a nice little twist and kick, especially because it's like similar to kind of eating like the spinach artichoke dip, and I'm a real good fan of that. So I add the spinach and the cheese into the ground beef and actually let that be in the dip, okay? So that is what the concept is tonight. That's the special little bonus with this recipe. And like I said, just because... I was gonna say if I had some spinach, I would have went ahead and thrown some on in there. But I do not have any. Oh, can't forget the taco season. All right. And I might just hold off on the cheesy. Well, nah, I'm gonna need a little bit because I ain't got enough in today. I won't need the whole pack. You know, like you're using like at least a half or a pound or a whole, you know, of course you're going to have to use more seasoning, but you know, you just do it to gauge it according to how much you're actually using and putting in there, okay? So go ahead and add any vegetables. Right? Like I said, if you haven't already, gone down below, okay, up under the box and go ahead and subscribe to the channel, okay? I enjoy spending time with y'all, right? How y'all feel about that? I want y'all to come back and visit me again, okay? Because we're doing some good business over here, man. This food, y'all have to smell it. You know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing like actually being right up on, okay? I want y'all to really enjoy this thing right in the comfort of your own home, all right? So, Let me just mention this as well. Put this garlic in here. And I get this from Walmart in the produce section. It's usually at the end down there on the aisle with baby tomatoes and stuff. You have to look down at the end and kind of look down low. So if your knees is bad like mine, you got a little kid that might help you out. Okay, probably be eye level for them. But you would have to do a little looking and a little ducking down to really get a good glimpse of it, all right? So I make sure that my meat is evenly spread at the bottom. And then I just add the cheese on top. Let the cheese layer the top of it. And then get at an opportunity to kind of just melt on there. And then what I'll do is I'll take it and start mixing it in. And, you know, be careful of the cheese getting down up under because you definitely don't want it to start burning. Oh, where? My assistant says I have some spinach. But I don't think I can. Yeah. I did. That's not spinach. That's celery.
That's celery. That's how much spinach in the bag.
It's not it. Thank you though. I think I used the last spinach when I did it, the wraps the last time. I put it in there. But I will do a recipe soon with the spinach. All right, so I'm going to use Now, can you put them in the trash can too? I like to clean as I go, y'all. Okay, it saves time and energy and effort at the end. So it's time to get ready to sit down and enjoy that meal. Okay. And I am going to put some salsa verde in there. Right. Telling y'all, I'm looking for some real good flavors. This is the business right here, so try that out. All right. And tell them that Jazz said it. Oh yes, it smells so good. All right, turn that back up. Let that simmer and cook. And we will be back shortly. All right, so this is the taco blend. Cheese, and so I put the cheese on there, and next we have some tomatoes. Right, some pickles. That is another bomb ingredient. I'm here to tell you if you never tried it. All right, some olives on there. And I'm not gonna put no onions on hers, but Coco likes a little hot stuff, so I'm gonna give her a couple of jalapenos, not much though. And then I'm gonna do sour cream. Salad oil. Give it a nice little kick too. And some pepper. And there you go. Let's see if we're going to get a test taste, a live test taste to see. Come tell me how you, what you think about it. This is my assistant, my lovely assistant, Coco. She's been good tonight helping out behind the scenes. So we're going to see what she thinks about this. Be careful.
Okay.
Don't bite your fingers off.
Okay, here I go.
Oh, really? You didn't even get none of the dip. You have to taste the dip, kinda.
Because I need to get the...
I don't even know why I even...
Okay, here I go.
Is it good? I don't know what you're saying. It sounds like it must be good because you can't really talk about it. So I'm gonna just take that as a. Is it thumbs up, thumbs down? Why don't you show me a sign? Thumbs up.
I was trying to be careful because my tooth hurts.
Okay, gotcha.
Because it's wiggly, my tooth is almost about to come out. All right,
so how
does
the food taste? How does the food taste?
Thumbs up. Don't be jelly.
All right, don't be jelly, y'all. All right, well, thank y'all for tuning in once again. It's your girl, Giselda, She Boss. Once again, if you didn't already, go on over to the website, www.sheboss21inc.com. Set up your free 30-minute strategy session. And also, if you haven't already, go down below, hit that subscribe button, and click the bell notifications for upcoming videos. If you're interested in the cooking ones, you can always check out the Cooking with a Concept series. Ladies, if you like beauty and makeup tutorials, I also have the Weed, Wine, and Wigs episode on this channel, okay? And for those of you all that just need a little motivation, you need that extra push, you need some words of encouragement when you're feeling down and you don't know who to call, you don't have anybody to talk to, I love to motivate the great, all right, not the hate. So y'all going on over... Scroll down, check out the videos, all right? Follow me on my other social media platforms. And if you need to contact me or purchase an item, please text 404-507-4805. As always, thank y'all. Have a blessed day. I speak nothing but infinite blessings and abundance on your life, your wealth, your health, your family, your community, your existence, and your love. Later.